Pre-planning is used in all aspects of the horizontal directional drilling process, whether it is planning the job site layout or the restoration. There should be a plan for it. One area that is commonly overlooked is creating a rod by rod bore plan. Have you ever wondered how you're going to navigate through a congested area? Or have you had to pull rods back during the pilot bore? Creating a bore plan gives you specific depths to follow and allows you to efficiently execute the pilot bore. I'm going to show you how to use quick math to create a bore plan on the job site. Please reference the Fundamentals of HDD User's Guide for more information. Before creating the proposed bore plan, it is important to know the location and depth of existing utilities and job site parameters. This may include the clearance needed around utilities and the desired depth of the new utility. If reaming is required, make sure to increase the utility clearance during the planning process. It is important to understand the allowable percent pitch per rod, HDD tooling, and ground conditions, along with the bend radius of the product being installed. HDD rods are designed to bend slightly, but if they're overbent, even once, they can be damaged and result in premature failure. Here's a chart that shows the Vermeer HDD machines and the drill rod specifications. For this example, I'm going to reference a D20 by 22 S3 Navigator horizontal directional drill, which has 10-foot rod and a max bend of 9.8%. Rounding this up to 10% for the maximum pitch change allows for quick math. Using this information and job site parameters, such as existing utilities and job site specifications, I can now use quick math to calculate a simple rod by rod plan on a piece of graph paper. For this example, the math will be in feet. Our parameters are 100-foot long bore, an approximate depth of 5 feet, and maintaining a 1.5-foot clearance around all utilities. An average drill setup on level ground will have the drill head position or angle sitting between negative 20% and negative 30%. For this reason, I will normally start my proposed bore plan with my first rod at a negative 25%. To calculate my first rod depth, I multiply the 10-foot rod by the current pitch of negative 25%. This equals negative 2.5 feet, which is the approximate depth change of the drill head once the full rod has been drilled into the ground. I'm going to draw my first rod on the graph, starting at the corner of the graph paper and go down approximately 2.5 feet and over 10 feet and make a dot. This represents the approximate depth of the drill head at the completion of the first rod. I like to write my predicted depth and pitch below to help me know where I'm at and how much I can change on the next rod. Since my drill head is at a negative 25% pitch, the maximum rod bend of 10% allows a change down to negative 35% or up to a negative 15% and anywhere in between. First, decide what depth you need to be at the end of rod 2. Then, figure out what pitch will get you there. For example, to get to 4 feet deep at the end of the second rod, I need to go 1.5 feet deeper. If I multiply the 10-foot rod by negative 15%, it equals negative 1.5 feet. Now I know I need to change to a negative 15% to be at 4 feet deep. After I draw that rod on my graph paper, I then write my current depth and pitch. Knowing that I want to be level at 5 feet deep leaves 2 more rods to achieve that depth. On rod 3, I'm going to change the pitch to a negative 10%, which will result in a 1 foot depth change, bringing the depth to 5 feet. Now, on the 4th rod, I can go to a 0% pitch and my depth will stay approximately at 5 feet deep. Knowing that it took 4 rods to get down to 5 foot and level, I'm going to maintain a 0% pitch for rods 5, 6, and 7. Before exiting the ground, it is best practice to have your bore path entry and exit at approximately the same pitch angles. On rod 8, I need to start gradually coming up. Knowing that I want to be at 4 feet at the end of this rod, a depth change of 1 foot is needed. To achieve this, I want to end this rod at a positive 10%. For rod 9, I want to end at a depth of 2.5 feet. Having a 1.5 foot depth change requires an ending pitch of positive 15%. The parameters of this bore were to exit the ground on my 10th rod. My current depth is 2.5 feet at a positive 15%. To exit the ground at the end of this rod, a 2.5 foot depth change is needed. A positive 25% pitch results in a 2.5 foot depth change. Drawing the last rod on my graph shows that at a positive 25% pitch, I exited the ground at the end of the 10th rod. It is important to note that these numbers are an approximation. Other variables that can affect planing will be ground conditions, topography, and HDD tooling. Using this quick math, you can be confident when making slight changes during the pilot bore process. Now that you understand what required information is needed, along with the quick math, you can create a bore plan on your next HDD job site.